Oke, okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, warahmatullahi
Good
wabarakatuh.
morning,
Good morning,
Good morning, Good morning. I hope that you already prepare yourself. Yeah. So remember this seminar practice. We hope that your performance is very similar to the real seminar. Now, the difference is that you don't need to do the presentation today because you have done it and I have watched your presentation. Now we directly to have the question and answer session, yeah, the discussion session. Now today, Yubelia become the note takers. Discussion Neneng Sarini and Sharifah Desi Ramadanti. Okay, I just want to directly to start the session ya by inviting Neneng. Tadi Neneng belum ada ya. Neneng Sarini had not yet come, so I would like to invite Sharifah Desi Ramadanti to start the discussion. So please have your session, I mean your time. Silakan, Desi.
All right, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. So today I will give the questions and suggestions to Aziansyah Irfal. Aziansyah Irfal proposal, I mean, sorry. Okay, and first, I would like to ask the questions about the proposal that I have read before. There is two questions that I still cannot understand with the proposal. So the first question is based on the background that I have seen before. I cannot see the differentiated between the reasons of the research that the reason that important to be conducted and with the problem in a particular classroom. So I mean here in the background, of course we akan mengandung reasons why the research is important, right? And then the particular problem of the classroom. Secara Aziansyah Irfal ini memilih classroom action research. Jadi berdasarkan yang saya baca, pada classroom action research itu harus ada the problem in a particular classroom. So because when I see in the background proposal, there is no differences between the research, the reasons why the research is important to conduct, and between the problem in a particular reason in the particular classroom. Okay, so I just want the explanation from Aziansyah Irfal about that. Thank you. And
okay, thank you so much. Yeah, thank you so much, Desi, for your question. So okay, so the reason why I use fan fictions is because using other literary works such as books or novel, they are rather boring and not interested for them to read, because what makes them really interest in reading is what they like, right? So that's why I use fan fiction, because in fan fiction, they can channel their inner childhood, like what the movie that they like or what the book that they like, and then they can channel it into fan fiction, because in fan fiction, there are many opportunity for them to read, because there are many. For example, if they are not, for example, in a movie, like in an Avengers movie, they are not really like the ending of it. But in fan fiction, Avengers movie can be a little bit different, because it is their own fan, their inner fan like to what they want to do with the with that fan fiction. So that's why I like to use fan fiction as the media for improving students' reading skills. So that's it, my reasons.
Okay, so that is the reason why you have why you use the fan fiction as your research media. But and what about the problem? What is the particular problem in the classroom sampai Anda bisa berpikir bahwa fan fiction ini bisa menyelesaikan problem itu? Thank you.
Particularly in the classroom, from my even in my own experience, students are rather boring reading a conventional book. So that's why I use fan fictions.
Okay, thank you very much. I think I can understand that. So I have one question and again. So in tools and data collections, I have seen that you will do the observation checklist and field notes, right? And for conduct your data and for the untuk menghasilkan hasilnya, Anda menggunakan observation checklist and field notes. Okay. So my question is it possible for you to make it become the strong result? Like maybe you give your students some tests, maybe for untuk menguatkan hasil dari data yang ingin Anda peroleh. Thank you.
Of course, with the collaboration of the teacher in the classroom, of course we are going to use fan fiction as the materials, and with that, with the observation. We will have a strong data about how can fan fiction impact their reading skills.
All right. I think that's clear enough. So thank you very much, Eva. Oh yeah, I forgot to give my suggestions. So my suggestion is, sorry to say, is probably in a literature review or frame of theory. Secara kan research-nya ini berfokus pada improve reading skills kan. Jadi yang saya lihat pada literature review atau frame of the story itu hanya memuat tentang fan fiction dan kalau tidak salah itu juga memuat hanya tentang reading skills ya. Jadi karena ini berfokus pada mengajar, sebaiknya menurut saya itu ditambahkan teori tentang cara mengajar reading tersebut. Saya pikir hanya itu. Terima kasih.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Sharifah. Very good discussion. Yeah. I hope the others also prepare your discussion, yeah, like what's already done by Sharifah. All right, so now we continue to invite the second discussion, Neneng Sarini. Please have your time.
All right, so I see info topic about fan fiction is really interesting because as we know, a lot of teenager right now is quite interesting in reading fan fiction. So you choose fan fiction as a material to teach on your class. So I think my question is, as a teacher, please mention genre and the title of fan fiction that may be suitable as a material to teach students in your class, and explain why you choose that title to teach your student. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Neneng Sarini. So first of all, it's not up to me for them, because for me, fan fiction is already a genre itself. So it's up to them for what they like. So it's up to them what fan fiction that they like to read. So that's why I bring up to them a few. I will ask them about, for example, what movie do you like, or what book, or whatever it is that you like, and if they can find it in the fan fictions, I think they will read it, because of course that's something that they like. So that's why they are going to read it. So I don't really tell them what title that they should read. So it's up to them.
All right, Eva. But I think if you give your student freedom like that, they will choose a genre that not suitable for teaching, because we know that fan fiction has a lot of genre. So I think some of students maybe will choose some genre that will not appropriate for using in teaching class, to using in class. So okay, what do you think about that? So how you, bagaimana Anda yakin student Anda itu bakal akan memilih genre yang tepat, begitu menurut saya.
Okay, thank you so much. Of course, we will filter them in the classroom with the collaboration of teachers. So we still melihat mereka gitu, apa yang akan mereka baca gitu, tetap kita akan filter. Jadi juga tidak akan semena-mena mereka akan membaca sesuatu yang mungkin tidak appropriate for the education, something like that.
All right, thanks, Yuval. I think your explanation is already clear for me. So, but I have one last question. I think, I want to ask, like, what make you interesting to use fan fiction in improving student reading skill? Because we know right now a lot of technique that already used to improving student reading skill, like reading a lot and etc. Because as we know, this is a modern era. So menurut saya tuh masih banyak gitu loh yang lebih bagus lagi dari fan fiction. Tapi mengapa Anda tuh memilih fan fiction seperti itu?
Okay, thank you. Very good questions. I discovered fan fiction in 2015. That's the first fan fiction that I read in Bahasa Indonesia. And it really hooked me because the quality of the content in the fan fiction, it's up to us for of what we like, right? And in my experience, my reading skill is also improved because of fan fiction. So that's why I use fan fiction for the improvement of reading skills.
All right, so it based on your experience. So I think it's already clear for me, and the suggestion for me maybe, I think you should add in the background of your proposal, I think you should add the reason why you choose this topic particularly. Maybe some reader want to know why you choose the topic. So I think that's it for me. Thank you.
Thank you, Neneng Sarini.
Okay, thank you, Neneng. Yeah, good question also. Yeah, and this good discussion. All right. Now, I would like to directly continue this. Yeah, because we still have time with this recording. All right. Now, I want to start from the overall comment. Yeah. Ini proposal secara esensi sudah lengkap ya, tetapi kalau untuk seminar sesungguhnya ini belum bisa karena masih kurang banyak hal yang kurang ya. Pertama introduction atau gini ya, saya pakai share screen saja. Okay, can you see my screen?
Yes, we can, sir.
Okay, now. kalau background ini kan cuma dua paragraf ya, very, very short. Background untuk apa ya, sebuah proposal itu ya kurang lebih dua halaman lah gitu ya. Jadi it's more or less two pages. Dan namanya background itu harus ada referensi. Kalau tidak ada referensi itu sama halnya kita itu cuma ngoceh doang gitu. Nah, sedangkan riset itu adalah academic work ya. So in academic work, we have to refer to someone sebagai apa bukti bahwa kita sudah baca dan sebagai bukti bahwa tulisan kita itu bukan asal ngomong gitu, tapi ada backup dari orang. Cuman kalau di background itu referensinya nggak boleh banyak-banyak. Ya, cari referensi yang sangat a very important reference. Ya, maybe you can have 2 or 3 references in your background. Ya. Jadi minimal misalkan contoh referensi model apa yang harus Anda seperti apa tentang apa yang harus Anda refer. Your topic is about reading skill and fan fiction. Jadi minimal itu adalah mungkin some work on reading skill, ya. Yeah. Misalkan very basic definition of reading. Misalkan reading is very basic. Definition of reading is to understand, because reading without understanding is not reading. Misalkan seperti itu, misalkannya. Nah, yang seperti itu kita harus ada referensinya. Misalkan aja itu ya. Nah, atau fan fiction. Sudah ada beberapa, kalau banyak mungkin sudah banyak para guru atau educators ya, around the world use fan fiction as the media for teaching, misalkan seperti itu, maka kamulah bikin sebuah referensi gitu. Nah itu ya. So you really need to work hard to improve your background. Tapi backgroundnya untuk classroom essay research itu agak spesifik. Nah sebelum saya jelaskan itu, saya mau konfirmasi dulu kepada kamu. Supaya judulnya itu benar-benar judul yang benar-benar ingin kamu lakukan. Sekarang saya I want you to confirm once again what is your research about. Nah, atau lebih spesifik yang sering saya tanyakan ke mahasiswa adalah what do you want to do in your research? What do you want to find out in your research? Nah, coba jawab pertanyaan itu aja, jangan ke mana-mana.
Okay, sir. What I want to find out in my research is, can fanfiction really improve reading skills, sir? That's the main point of my research, sir.
Okay. So, classroom action research is okay then. So, if you want to know how, for example, fanfiction, yeah, the use of fanfiction in teaching reading improve the reading skills, the quality of reading skills of students. Yeah. Nah, kalau begitu berarti, so in your background, you need to talk. Yeah. First, as I told you before, yeah, when you frame, structure your introduction, itu adalah upside down pyramid, kan? Jadi maksudnya yang bagian atas itu agak umum, tetapi jangan terlalu umum, ya. Langsung masalah tentang ini kan teaching reading, berarti it's about reading. So your topic, I mean your first paragraph is should talk about reading. Itu sebenarnya sini sudah bagus ya. Reading have become a part of student life, blah blah blah, sebenarnya ya. Bolehlah seperti itu ya. Nah, kemudian yang bagian penting di dalam background untuk classroom action research, kamu harus menceritakan tentang masalah. Nah, tapi bukan di paragraf pertama, mungkin di paragraf ketiga, keempat, kamu bicara tentang the problem of the classroom. The class that you are going to do the classroom action research, yeah, activities. Jadi kalau mahasiswa memilih classroom action research, itu tandanya dia sudah pasti, sudah jelas penelitiannya itu di mana. Kalau kalian itu belum ngerti mau meneliti di mana, ya itu enggak bisa classroom action research. Apakah Azianza sudah tahu di mana mau menelitinya? Sudah yakin? Gimana Azianza?
Yes, sir.
Do you know where? Apakah are you already decided? Yeah. I mean, have you already decided where you want to do your research?
Yes, sir. I actually wanted in to do the research in the junior high school.
In where? Junior high school. Where?
Junior high school.
Sir. Yeah, where?
In SMP 3 near my place, sir. SMP 3 Sungai Kakap.
Nah, itu bukan anu ya. Bukan kira-kira, itu harus karena kalau classroom action itu harus sudah jelas tempatnya di mana penelitian itu. Nah, gitu.
Yes.
Oke. Nah, itu harus dijelaskan masalahnya di situ. Kemudian kamu menjelaskan tentang fan fiction. Fan fiction itu dijelaskan bukan secara teori panjang lebar, bukan, bahwa fan fiction itu diperkirakan bisa menjadi solusi dari masalah yang kamu ungkapkan tadi. Nah, jadi ada koneksi. There is a connection between between your problem and solution that you propose. Your problems and fan fiction as the solution that you propose in your research projects. Gitu.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Nah, ini sekali lagi your work, I mean your job is to fix this introduction. Ya, okay, yang sir. Kira-kira minimal itu 2 halaman begitu. Kemudian research questions ini kurang pas kalau untuk classroom action research, ya. How does kalau ini yang pertama oke. Okay. How does the use of, ya? How does the use of fan fiction in teaching reading improve students with S apostrophe like gini. Ya, students reading skills.
Sir.
Ya, student reading skill. Jadi reading skill enggak mungkin cuma satu. Yeah. Jadi how does the use of fan fiction to improve how does the use of fan fiction improves students, yeah. Nah, maksudnya di sini adalah the use of fan fictions in teaching reading in blah 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 blah, ya, yeah, improve student reading skills, ya, yeah, gitu. Kemudian kalau untuk classroom action research, ya sebenarnya cukup satu begitu aja sudah tidak apa-apa.
Oh,
kalau
okay,
what specify the fan fiction to be the tool? I don't understand what you mean by this. Can you elaborate? Number two. What do you mean by question number two?
Yes, sir. Sebenarnya, I just want to add something to the research question because I thought research question must have 2 questions at least, sir. That's why I add that, sir. I add that question.
Yeah, yang paling penting dalam kelas research itu satu itu aja sudah cukup, nomor satu itu. Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Nanti kalau ada saran di seminar, ya silakan aja nanti dilihat. Tapi untuk sebuah proposal, satu itu sudah cukup, ya. Yeah. Oke. Next, purpose disesuaikan aja nanti signifikan. Ini saya tidak perlu komentar karena itu nanti aja. Ya, terminologi ini dia. Reading skills. Dan blablabla. And fan fiction is a fiction. Nah itu ini nggak jelas nih. What do you mean by fan fiction? What do you mean by fan fiction? Because this definition is not clear.
Make it more clear, sir.
Yeah, sekarang tell me, what do you mean by fan fiction?
Fan fiction is a fiction, sir, that
in your research, what do you mean by fan fiction? Is it a movie? Is it a novel? Is it a short story and so on like that?
In my research, fan fiction is I think it's all of that, sir, because fan fiction can cover all of that. Movie.
All of what?
Movie, book.
So you mean that you are going to use all of this?
Of course not, sir, because
yeah.
That
makanya, so terminology itu adalah term yang berlaku hanya in your research. So you can define this very specific definition.
Oh, okay, sir.
Okay, ya. Nanti dibetulin aja ini pokoknya. So fan fiction is what? So you have to once again to describe this here, but not in long definition. Yeah, this namanya juga terminology. So this short definition but clear. Yeah, make the terminologies that you use in your proposal become clear by reading the terminology section. So you have to. For example, reading skill. Also, you have to explain what you mean by reading skill in your research. Yeah, do not go very theoretical. Kalau theoretical, ya apa? Kalau theoretical ya kita anu lah. Maksud saya bukan di sini tempatnya, tapi di literature review gitu. Tetapi kalau untuk apa? Untuk terminologi kita harus benar-benar spesifik itu. Alright. Aduh, kita kehabisan ini nih. Kehabisan waktu ya. Maksudnya udah kena warning nih 10 menit lagi. Oke. Okay. Nanti kita sambung ya. Sebentar. Jadi sekali lagi yaitu terminologi dan terminologi itu bisa harusnya kalau untuk sebuah proposal yang baik itu ya agak banyak lah, jangan cuma dengan dua gini. Terminologi itu bisa muncul dari istilah-istilah dimanapun ya. Maksud saya tidak hanya di title of your research, but it can be the terms that you use in your writing ya. Yeah. Tetapi kalau memang tidak ada ya tidak usah ngade-ngade gitu. Artinya tidak usah ditambah-tambah kalau memang tidak ada yang mau ditambahkan lagi.
Oke, sir.
Ya. Alright. Oke. Kita lanjutkan di habis terminologi apalagi ini. Kalau untuk apa classroom action research ini sudah oke. Ada purpose, significant, and terminology. Setelah itu adalah frame of theory. Ya, frame of theory sudah oke. Okay setelah itu ya. Oke, okay, karena waktunya habis, kita sambung dengan link yang baru ya. Sorry ya, okay, Aziansa, quickly rejoin ya. Di riset kamu itu keywordnya ada berapa? Aziansa, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Reading skills, fan fictions.
Yeah, reading skill. Jadi, apa keyword di title ini tiga ya tiga keywords ya. Pertama yes, improving sir. Student
improve.
Nah improving itu sama dengan teaching ya, Tapi teaching in your case is teaching reading. Kan ini kan pasti tentang teaching reading kan? Berarti ya it's about teaching reading. Makanya di terminologi harusnya juga ada teaching reading. Ya.
Okay, sir.
Kemudian reading skill. Nah, ini terminologi juga. Karena in your research you will talk lots about reading skills. Yang ketiga adalah fan fiction. These three things in your research ini harus masuk di literature review, this frame of theory. Nah, kalau menurut saya, ya saran saya kamu bicara tentang teaching reading dulu. Yeah, because it's reading skill is included in the section of teaching reading.
Jadi, okay,
so you can divide your theory into two parts. The first part is teaching reading, and the second part is fan fiction. So in teaching reading section, you talks about the definition of teaching. Particularly teaching reading. Nah, teaching itu kan banyak definisinya, from very general to very specific for your research. Your research definition of teaching must be teaching reading. Kamu jelaskan apa arti teaching reading. Kan teaching reading, teaching speaking, teaching listening, teaching writing itu kan beda-beda. Kan tidak bisa mengatakan misalnya teaching reading is exactly the same as teaching reading writing, misalkan tidak bisa. Teaching reading dan teaching writing itu beda. Ah gitu. Makanya setiap tapi kamu jangan bahas semuanya, cuman bahas hanya teaching reading. So you talk about teaching language, you can talk about the theories of second language acquisition. TEFL, yeah. Teaching English as foreign language, yeah, in general. You talk at there, and then why in the context of foreign language, for example, like that. And then what's the challenges about teaching reading in foreign language context, and something like that. And then di bagian kedua, di section pertama, yaitu teaching reading, you talks about reading skills. What you mean by reading skills? Apakah you are talking about, so here you are talking about phonemics, vocabulary and so on. Kalau phonemics ini kan ngajar reading anak TK. Ini kan masih spelling kayak gitu. Memang itu reading juga, that's correct, ya. Yeah? Starting reading itu kan we recognize letters, sound, and so on like that. Tapi apakah itu yang you maksud dalam your research? If they are not included in your research, so do not talk in your proposal. Jadi proposal itu bukan untuk membahas seluruhnya. Phonics betul, itu juga masalah reading. That's correct. But this topic is not included in your topic. So that's why do not talk. Only talk something relevant to your research. Yeah. Nah, sekarang saya mau nanya, ngetes jadi reading skill itu apa? Seperti apa yang reading skill itu apa kira-kira reading?
Reading skill for me, reading skill is a skills that we need to have in order for us to read, sir.
Berarti Anda belum baca.
Baca sedikit ya, sir. Emang belum tahu gitu
semua. Ya, makanya gitu, itu challenge-nya. Cari buku yang langsung, buku-buku misalkan Brown kayak gitu kan, yang bicara masalah reading. Teaching reading, kemudian cari reading yang memang yang membahas masalah reading skill itu banyak sekali. Nah, reading skill nanti banyak ya strategi di dalam membaca. Ada ya reading comprehension kalau kamu maksudnya, makanya tadi itu reading skill itu apakah larinya ke reading comprehension. Kalau reading comprehension kan ya skillnya itu seperti ya termasuk vocabulary, betul, vocabulary in context, kemudian misalkan topik ya, kemudian misalkan details, inferences, references dan sebagainya kayak gitu kan. So these all skills yeah, needed in order to understand the text. So all these topic should be discussed in your section. The second part of the first section. The first section is teaching reading.
Teaching reading.
Kemudian bagian the first part in teaching reading, you talk about the definition of teaching reading. The second partnya baru ini tentang reading comprehension reading ataupun reading skill tadi. Nah, the second part of your literature is fun fiction. Oh. Nah, di sini kamu menjelaskan tentang fun fiction. Sekarang saya mau nanya, apakah kamu, are you clear already fun fiction? Seperti yang ditanya oleh Neneng tadi. Apa aja fun fiction-nya kan bisa macam-macam gitu. Yang tadi, bagaimana kamu memilihnya? Siapa tadi yang nanya itu? Kan tidak semua, Neneng ya, tidak semuanya appropriate. Ya, yeah, I agree with that one. Nah, maksud saya kalau dalam riset, dalam proposal, kamu harus sudah jelas fan fiction apa yang mau kamu gunakan.
Oke, sir.
Apa? Can give you mention one, just to give, so then I can explain as example.
For example, fan fiction of MCU, Marvel Cinematic Universe. Of course, who don't know about MCU, sir?
Siapa? Sam?
Fan fiction about, for example,
the
MCU.
The title of the fan fiction that you are going to use.
Or the title, sir?
Yes. Just example.
Just example. For example, like Harry Potter, sir.
Harry Potter, for example. Jika kamu sudah jelas, misalkan, you akan menggunakan Harry Potter seri 1, seri 2, seri 3, misalkan seperti itu. So, you have to explain here. So, fan fiction. Oh. First, you have to talk about the definition, general definition of fan fiction. And second, and then you continue to fan fiction that you are going to use in your research. Harry Potter. So then you talk about Harry Potter. It's kind of the explanation of like the general synopsis, not a detailed synopsis. Maybe just a little background about the Harry Potter that you are going to focus on. Seperti itu. Kalau itu sudah ya tadi ya. Berarti di fan fiction itu yang pertama kamu harus bahas tentang apa itu fan fiction secara umum. Kemudian di bagian keduanya kamu membahas fan fiction yang akan kamu pakai.
Okay, sir.
Seperti apa. Nah, bagian ketiga dari literature review kamu harus membahas few research already conducted about your topic. Fan fiction and reading. Nah, itu ada enggak penelitian itu? Kalau fan fiction belum ada, mungkin fiction gitu ya. Kalau fiction belum ada, mungkin kalau itu larinya ke arah reading, reading novel, berarti novel and reading. Kalau novel pasti banyak sudah penelitian tentang itu.
Oke, okay, Bu. Nah,
so you need to review a few research already conducted on your topic, yeah, maybe about 3 or 4 research, yeah, yang very current, yeah.
Okay, sir.
Okay, now next methodology. You talked about car, yes. Nah, tetapi sayang kamu tidak ada referensi sama sekali. Car is yes. Very theoretical. I mean, you cannot just talks about car without mentioning any references. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sorry, I forgot, sir.
Yeah, ini harusnya sudah ini yang namanya CAR itu pasti kita menggunakan semua ide orang, tetapi jangan ide dari skripsi, jangan ide dari penulis yang kedua ketiga, harusnya dari the first writer. Saya sudah upload buku yang kemarin ya, buku tentang doing action research in language teaching itu, in English language teaching itu bagus sekali oleh Anne Byrne yang menjadi referensi utama mahasiswa dan juga dosen-dosen, karena itu memang bagus sekali for doing classroom action research. So please read that one. It's very clear, not very hard English. Yeah, it's really, I think that book is written specifically for students like you. Yeah, so it's easier.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
And also please use reference here, yeah, using that book.
Okay.
Ini karena tidak pakai buku ya susah saya ngelakukan. Ini kan planning ya. Kok ada apply, ada observe, ada reflect. Ya kalau kamu menggunakan buku pasti bunyinya menjadi planning, acting, observing, reflecting gitu. Ya kan seperti itu ya. Oke, the participants of this research, certain group, yang disebut itu jumlah students-nya. Bukan grade 7, bukan, tapi ya grade 7. Misalkan participants are 40 students from grade 7 SMP. Kayak gitu.
Okay.
Dan, tidak sesingkat ini. You have to talk also about that school, yeah, the curriculum, perhaps more information about SMP 3 Sungai Kakap. Tapi bukan cerita tentang alamatnya, bukan. Tapi if we talk about the specific characteristic of that school, yeah, in term of learning English. Okay. Next, technique and tool of data collection. Technique of data collection, observation, measurement. Yes. Ini sudah oke. Okay. Tool of data observation checklist. Nah, di sini kamu harus harus dibahas apa itu observation checklist. Maksud saya ini adalah tempat. This is the space for you to explain your tools, your instrument. Jadi di sini ada tempat. Misalkan kita sudah punya. Bukan hanya misalkan, seharusnya ya kamu sudah punya observation checklist. Nah, nanti kalau di real seminar, you have to have already observation checklist. Nah, udah ada ya, misalkan nih, saya pegang nih. Nah, di sini adalah menjelaskan tentang yang ini nih, yang udah jadi nih. Kamu jelaskan di sini. So, observation checklist, misalkan, to be used is in order to collect the information about blah, 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 blah. So the observation checklist is in three parts, misalkan. There will be, katakanlah, 15 questions or 15 statements, ya, dengan misalkan yes, no, tick, ya. So just to indicate whether something happening or not happening, something like that. Jadi di sinilah tempatnya kamu menjelaskan itu. Kemudian di sini juga kamu menjelaskan menyebutkan misalkan observation checklist-nya itu ada di appendix sekian. Nah, di sini cepatnya. Jadi jangan tiba-tiba ada appendix tapi you never mention in your proposal. Ya. Field note juga sama, ya. Nah, cuman kan kamu ada tadi measurement, tapi di sini nggak ada toolsnya. Harusnya ada juga tools untuk measurement. Kalau field note sama observation checklist itu hanya tools untuk observation. So observation can be done, can be carried out, dapat dilakukan dengan cara satu menggunakan observation checklist. Dua, dengan field note. Sama-sama itu kan, sama melihat. Ketiga, yeah, dengan recording. Misalkan video recording. Itu observation. Sekarang measurement. So, measurement you don't have the tools. Jadi, ini masih kurang satu. Measurement itu apa? Tools-nya. Apa azan, sir?
The data that have been gathered, sir. Before and after. The data that have been gathered before and after the treatment, sir.
Itu bukan custom action research kalau kayak gitu. Alatnya apa? Measurement itu. Sekarang measurement. Sekarang you sebut measurement. Measurement ini untuk ngukur apa? What you want to measure?
Oh yeah, the effectiveness of, is it really work?
Jangan sebut itu lagi. Saya bilang itu adalah experimental research. Kalau kita bicara effectiveness, itu eksperimental. Kamu kan improving. Itu classroom action research. Yang di measure itu adalah reading skill. Kan gitu. Apakah reading skill-nya itu tinggi, rendah, atau baik, buruk, sedang. Nah, gimana caranya? Bagaimana cara ngukurnya?
I'm not sure.
Itu ya dengan reading test lah.
So, oh iya, astagfirullah.
Reading test.
Ya, reading test, astagfirullah.
Nah, so the tools for data collection, yang ketiga adalah reading test. Nah, reading test itu, bagaimana cara membuatnya, sangat tergantung dari literature review yang you bahas di atas. Misalkan reading skill yang kamu bahas itu ada 5 reading skill. Misalkan ya, skill 1, skill 2, skill 3, skill 4, dan skill 5. Maka tesnya itu harus bisa mendeteksi 5 skill itu. Kalau di literature review itu kamu bahas cuma 3 skill, maka tes kamu itu harus bisa mendeteksi 3 skills reading. So it really depends on the literature review that you already presented earlier of this proposal. Nah itu ya, jadi ada berapa pertanyaan, harus ada cerita tentang table of specification, yang itu tadi ya, pertanyaan nomor berapa aja tentang skill ini, pertanyaan nomor berapa aja tentang skill itu, dan sebagainya. So that's the instrument atau tools of data collection. Nah, di dalam riset proposal yang sesungguhnya, semuanya ini harus sudah ada. Observation checklist-nya sudah ada. Jangan pula waktu seminar kosong semuanya ini. Nah, rugi, karena justru dosen akan memberikan feedback di bagian ini. Nah, kalau belum ada, nanti sudah seminar bingung lagi. Karena kita tidak ada, kan? Nah, kalau sudah ada, nanti akan diobrak-abrik sama dosen biasanya nih bagian ini. Tapi menjadi makin jelas, your research become very clear after your seminar, ya. Jangan after seminar masih bingung, itu salah. So you have to complete this, so that this berarti kan tambah satu, berarti kamu ada tes, jadi reading test di sini.
Yes sir, reading test.
Jadi reading test. Nah, ketiga-tiga hal ini harus sudah ada. Jadi jangan hanya ada penjelasannya tapi barangnya tidak ada. Sebarangnya sudah ada, kamu letakkan setelah referensi. Namanya appendix. Oke? Okay? Nah, terakhir referensi. Referensi ini masih salah, ya. Ini tidak ada model kayak gini, ya. So please once again look at our journal, JIT itu. Semua referensi di sana sudah menggunakan APA style. Ya, bagaimana? Ini tadi saya sudah cek yang ini sudah saya cek. Ya, ini bagus dalam arti jurnal artikel. Tapi kalau yang ini nggak bisa. Ya, kamu harus cari yang jurnalnya. Tetapi ini salah menulisnya saja, menulis referensinya salah.
Ini
juga salah. Bagaimana caranya? Kemarin saya sudah upload contoh artikel kan di grup kita. So please follow that reference style. Oke?
Okay? Okay, sir.
Okay. Alright, I think that's all ya from me. Nah, apakah ada pertanyaan atau sanggahan ya from you? Silakan. kalau ada.
From me, sir.
Yes. Do you have any questions?
Oh, yeah.
Any, you know, let's say doubts or confusion. So
yes, sir, yes.
Good opportunity to ask.
Okay, sir. About observation checklist, sir. So we need, to make it first, right? Before we do the seminar, sir.
Yeah. Because... Yes. Not only observation checklist, but also tests.
Oh, after the reading test. Yeah. Oh, after the reading test, sir.
Yes. Nah, kalau reading test itu tidak mesti kamu sendiri yang bikin. Kamu boleh mengambil dari reading test yang sudah dipakai orang, asalkan ada referensinya dan ada penjelasannya. Why you take this your instrument, or you can take some parts and remove some parts and add some more. It's kind of modification. That's what we call adaptation. Yeah, you can adapt and adopt. Yeah, the instrument by others as far as you have explained. Yeah, sepanjang ada penjelasan kenapa begini, kenapa begitu, is acceptable. Otherwise, you have to create the brand new test for your.
Yeah.
For your own purposes. Okay?
Okay, that's all, sir.
Okay, kalau memang sudah, berarti sampai di situ ya. Yes. Good luck ya for this seminar. Ya, yang jelas judul kamu sudah okay, tinggal diperbaiki. Saya kira dari hari ini. Tadi temanmu juga sudah memberikan banyak pertanyaan dan masukan, bagus juga. Juga dari saya, nanti bisa diakses. Ya. Yang rekaman kemarin saya sedang mempersiapkannya, baru karena harus saya gabungkan lagi, saya edit sedikit. Nah, juga rekaman ini akan saya siapkan for you, so then you can access later in order to improve the quality of your proposal. So we do hope that soon after you finish this subject, next meta you are ready to do real seminar ya. Siapa tahu ya angkatan 2019 ini bisa lulus banyak sebelum 4 tahun ya, harapan kita 4 tahun. Kita kan mau akreditasi internasional nih kan. Nah, harapannya kalian contribute in this part ya. Makanya khususnya mahasiswa yang benar-benar proposalnya sebenarnya tinggal sedikit diperbaiki aja. So I really want you to work harder to really catch up ya, the revision. Jadi misalkan kemarin siapa Abdul Malik ya, sekarang Azian Sa, kan banyak nih waktunya. So please work harder. Jangan merasa oh saya udah selesai nih gitu kan. Jadi lebih santai, tidak begitu. Justru sekarang kamu harus memperbaiki proposalnya semaksimal mungkin, sesempurna mungkin. So then later we can you know depend on you. Maksudnya kita bisa mengandalkan kalian untuk bisa lulus cepat gitu. So you can improve the rank of our prodi. Sekarang sudah international scale. Alright, I think that's it. So for today, good luck for everyone. So the next presenter, siapa nih? Next week will be Haikal Doni Pratama dan Silpa Norida Sitompul. So I want you to get ready with your proposal and also your presentation and your recording. Yeah, 10 menit recording maksimal for your presentation. Alright, so I would like to close this session. Yeah, thank you very much for your attention. So I see you again next week, insyaAllah. Yeah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good morning. Good luck for your study.
Waalaikumsalam. Thank you so much.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.